Welcome to week three of Virtual AWANA Club at Steele Creek, Eastfield. You say, where in the world is Miss Becky this week? Well, I'm at Virginia Beach. The waves are really churning this morning. It's been kind of rainy, but it's been good because we had a good vacation out here. Anyway, we're going to have pretty much the same format this week. Start out with our flag fanfare and our Pledge of Allegiance to the flag, to the Bible. And then again, there are two videos, one for TNT, one for Sparks. You can do both if you'd like. The TNT video, they're going to be talking about a book called Grace in Action and a different Bible verse than what you may be working in. Don't worry about it. I just wanted you to have the principle that God is the creator. In Sparks' video, it's more of a missions video talking about Rwanda, this country in Africa. I hope that you were able to get your books if you didn't already have them last Sunday at church. If you didn't, that's okay. I'll be there this Sunday and you can get your book from me then. Congratulations to Winnie Blakes. She's the one that emailed me and let me know what I misquoted in 2 Timothy 2:15. I hope she enjoys her Walmart gift card. Again, just a reminder, TNTers, make sure that you do the start here, the explore, and the memorize section before you allow an adult to sign off on your books. And two more weeks after this one and we get to be back together. So until then, remember, Jesus loves you. Bye-bye. All right, clubbers, let's go through the opening flag ceremony. AWANA Club attention. Present colors. Right hand salute. Pledge to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and for the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now let's do the pledge to the Bible. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path, and will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God. Order arms. You got to do the pop there. And then post colors. And that's our opening flag ceremony, boys and girls.
So this is Angelique. She and her family live in Rwanda. Now, Rwanda is in Africa. Let's see where that is in the world. Here's a map of the whole world. That little green arrow, well, that's America. And that little red circle, that's Rwanda. See, it's right here. Now let's zoom in a little closer and see what it looks like. This is Africa. See Rwanda still in that little red circle? Yep, it's right there. Now I wonder what it looks like if we go even closer. Rwanda has some beautiful sights to see, and it has some city stuff too. I would love to visit Rwanda one day. Now back to Angelique. She and her family speak Kinyarwanda. That's the language of Rwanda. Now, hello in Kinyarwanda is this word. And here's how you pronounce it.
Muraho. Muraho.
So let me give it a try. Muraho, Sparkies. I don't know how I did. What do you think? You give it a try. Muraho, Sparkies. Angelique went to AWANA just like you do, but she was not a Christian when she first started attending AWANA. It was at AWANA that she learned that the Lord Jesus is the light of the world, and she believed that he died for her sins or her disobedience. She loved him and she trusted him. Now her family saw a change in her and they wanted to live life the way that she did. So what do you think that means? What kind of changes would they have seen in Angelique? Maybe she was more obedient, or maybe she didn't back talk as much. Maybe she read her Bible. Yeah, you've got a Bible, right? Maybe she read her Bible and they saw her doing that. Or maybe she was a little kinder than she used to be, or she shared her things more. Maybe she just showed that she cared about others more. Maybe she sang praise songs. What do you think? Pause the video for just a minute and talk with the people around you about what Angelique's family and friends might have seen in her to make them notice that something was different. So I have a question for you. Can people tell that there's something different about you just by the things they see you doing? You see, Angelique didn't just learn about the Lord Jesus, the light of the world, and keep it to herself. No, she reflected that light to her family and to those around her. So let's try something. I want you to close your eyes. Now go ahead, close your eyes, like this. What do you see? Yeah? Well, if you follow directions and you didn't peek, then you didn't see anything. It was just dark, right? Now imagine the whole world like that. The whole world without any light. Now, what are some things that you think it might be difficult to do without that light? Now, if your eyes are still closed, go ahead and open them. What are some things that it would be difficult to do without light? Driving? Yeah, definitely. Reading, going to school, those are all things that would be difficult to do without light. I have a little story to share with you. When I was a young girl, probably around 10 years old, maybe a little bit younger, I had a bike and I would ride my bike to my friend's house and she kind of lived up a little, it's not a big hill, but it's just a little bit of a slope. And I would ride it back home and I did it so much that I thought I could do it with my eyes closed. So one day when I was leaving her house on my bike, I closed my eyes and I put my hands on the handlebars and I started pedaling. And the next thing you know, I smacked right into a mailbox. It wasn't so easy to ride a bike in the dark. Some things are just not meant to be done in the dark. Now, we have electricity to bring light to our homes. But when the electricity goes out because of a storm, we often use candles to help us see in the darkness. You know, during Bible times, the people had to use candles. They didn't have electricity. They used candles and they used oil lamps. And they would often put them high on a lampstand to create as much light as possible. Now we're going to read Matthew chapter 5 verses 14 through 16 from our Bibles. So if you don't have your Bible, run and go get it real quick. Go get those Bibles. You're going to need it. Now Matthew is in the New Testament. Remember, we've got the Old Testament and the New Testament. Matthew is the first book of the New Testament. We're going to be in chapter 5 and we're going to read verses 14 through 16. So let's hear what they have to say. Verse 14. You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Verse 15, neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on a stand and it gives light to everyone in the house. And verse 16, in the same way, let your light shine before others that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. The Lord Jesus wants us to be lights in a dark world. He wants us to let Him shine through our actions so that others can see Him. But sometimes we hide our lights, our love for the Lord Jesus, because we're afraid of what others might say to us, or we're afraid that they might tease us. Yeah. But when we live the way that Jesus wants us to live, others can see how much we love him. Angelique let the Lord shine through her, and her parents noticed a difference. And they came to trust in the Lord Jesus too, because of what they saw in her life. Do you live the way God wants you to live? Can other people see the Lord Jesus Christ in your life? Something to think about. So Sparkies, there are two important truths that we need to remember from today's lesson. Are you ready? Number one, God loves all people all around the world. That's you, that's me, that's Angelique and her family, all people all around the world. And number two, all people who have trusted in Jesus as Savior, who say that they love Jesus, should let their lights shine before others so that others will see their good works and will glorify their Father in heaven. You see, guys, God has given us a special light in us, and he wants us to shine that light so that others can see it, because that light is going to point to him, and it's going to show the world how much he loves them. So let's pray for Angelique and for her people and for the AWANA missionaries in her country. And we're going to pray that we would be people who reflect the love of Jesus, who shine his light in the world. Let's pray. Father, thank you for Angelique and for her story and for the things that we can learn from her. I pray for Angelique and for her family. I pray that you would protect them, and I pray that your light would continue to shine through them, so that others see their works and praise you. Lord, I pray for the AWANA missionaries in Angelique's area. I pray that you would give them opportunities to share your love. And Lord, I pray for us. I pray that we would shine your light to those around us every day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Okay, Miss Becky, is there anything else for tonight?
Yes, we've got one whole nother section to our AWANA night.
Well, what is it?
It's called small group time or handbook time.
Oh, that's cool.
That's when you'll be able to work through your handbooks. If you are in kindergarten through second grade and have never been to AWANA before, you'll start in this Flight 316 entrance test.
Wow, what if I don't have one?
Well, you'll get one from the AWANA table at church on Sunday.
Cool.
We'll have them here. And once you finish this, then you become a member of our AWANA club and you can get your vest.
A member?
A member, yes.
Wow, and they get a vest?
And they get a vest. The Sparks get a red vest.
Oh, that's cool.
If you've already done this last spring and you're in your hang glider book, you will just continue to work in your hang glider book.
So we start back where we left off?
Yes.
Oh, that's cool, yeah.
If you are in TNT.
TNT, what's that?
That's Truth and Training, that's the 3rd through 5th or 6th grade clubbers.
Okay.
You will start in the start zone, regardless of whether you did it last year. They always start back in the start zone. This is your entrance test, and if you don't have a uniform yet, you will get a uniform when you finish this.
So we get the AWANA shirt when we finish that book?
Yes. It's a soccer-style jersey, and you get to put chevrons on it.
A chevron? What's that?
Sections. It's a little...
Oh, like the military.
Like military,
like the commanders have.
Yes.
Wow. That's cool.
Now, in the email, you received, this is part of the email. This is going to be an activity that you're going to be able to go do first thing when you go to small group time.
For who?
This is for the Sparks.
Oh, Sparks.
Sparks.
Mm-hmm.
If you're in TNT, what you will do is you will do the welcome portion, the first section in the handbook. That's going to be your activity for today. And I want to say a few things to the adults as they help you sign off sections. A section You just keep going in the section.
How do we know where to end?
I'm going to show you. You get down here, section one complete.
Oh, it says complete. Okay.
It tells you everything that you have to do. Each week in the TNT handbook, there will be a start here section. That's an activity that you can do, the parents and clubbers can do together. Then there is an explore section. It's kind of like a little Bible study. That it'd really be nice if the parents could do it with their children also. And then there's the memorize section. It's where there's a Bible verse each week for a clubber to memorize.
Oh, this sounds like the pledge. I will hide its word in my heart that I might not sin against him.
That's one of the big reasons why we think Bible memorization is a very good idea.
But what if I can't remember the whole thing?
Oh, well, then you just block it into little sections and learn a little section at a time. You can put the words to music. You can have a contest and go back and forth and each say the next word to the Bible verse and see who can go further.
Oh, that's cool. Like with my mom and dad?
Yes, mom and dad, brothers and sisters, grandma, grandpa.
But how will they know if I've learned it?
They will have the Bible verse here.
And then what happens when can I say it to them?
You say it to them. When you've said it to them, they sign here.
But sometimes I get scared. What if I mess up a little bit? Can they help me?
Sure. The guidelines for Bible memorization, AWANA style, is that each child gets two helps per section when they memorize their verses. A help is 3 to 4 words. And once they've said that, they also need to say the reference or where it's found, John 3:16. So if there's sometime they don't have their Bible, they'll know where it's found or what the reference is. They can go back and look it up.
That's great.
And once that's complete, the parents can sign them off.
Well, Becky, do you think the parents are going to learn any Bible verses?
Oh, I know the parents will learn Bible verses. I learn the Bible verses when I listen to the clubbers every week.
So that's a really cool thing. Okay, is there anything else?
I think maybe we need to finish in prayer.
That's good. And then we're going to be doing this every week, right?
Yes, every week you'll get an email with instructions and a large group time message. All right, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much for the technology we have so we can still have AWANA even if we can't meet together, dear Lord. And we just pray that you will be with these clubbers, that you'll excite them to memorize God's word, and you'll keep them safe, and we will see them next week online. In Jesus' name, amen.